In today, today, if you ask today these people who disbelieve in Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, ask them, how did Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam brought all this information? What do you think Muhammad is? They will tell you, wallahi, they will tell you he was a genius man. They will tell you he had access to Aramaic, the language of Jesus. He had access to the Persian language. He had access to someone from Rome. He had and he says, subhanAllah, this is somebody who has been 300 years. If you want to have access to all the civilization and understand the languages, even themselves, they don't have what the Quran say about their own religions. They're still discovering till today. We have in the Quran all the miracles of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and the request that the people have asked from him is not, does not exist in the Bible. They still do research today while we're talking, to find out where the scrolls that says about this, so we can match with what the Quran say. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the true messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the true messenger of God. These people, he is the most honest, they say he's a liar. Calling them for one God, and they say, no, many gods is better for us. And defending the idols, and being patient and fighting for the idols, which is all illogical, all does not make sense. All you can look at is this, how can somebody fight the truth? We said the last week, if somebody continues sinning, if somebody keep on sinning, it makes the truth falsehood. It makes the falsehood truth. And that's what we live in, this situation we live in at the moment. Then they show some more, the kuffar. They say, أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ الذِّكْرُ مِنْ بَيْنِنَا. So, it's not the Quran they refuse, it's not the oneness of God, it's not Muhammad. No. Was he selected? Was he only the person? Was he the only person? Was he the only the right one? Why was he only selected? Why not me? Why not my cousin? Why, you know? So it is jealousy. It is tribal. It's why Muhammad? Why Banu Hashim? Why this tribe, not this tribe? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بَلْ هُمْ فِي شَكٍ مِّن ذِكْرِي بَلْ لَمَّ يَذُوقُوا عَذَابٍ. It's nothing about you, it's nothing about the Quran. It is about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the reminder. Because they have not seen punishment yet. This is the bottom line. People disbelieve because they have not seen the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the calamity and the disaster has not befallen them personally. And then Allah asked them, why you question something like that? Why you ask, why Muhammad? Why the Arab? Why in the Quran revealed to them? Allah says to them, أَمْ عِنْدَهُمْ خَزَائِنْ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. Are they in control of the treasure, of the mercy of Allah? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that decides. If someone says, why you have this? He's questioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's gift. And then Allah raises another question and says, أَمْ لَهُمْ مُلْكُ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. Or they control the universe, the heavens and earth and everything in between. Let them show us. Why are they rejecting? Why are they fighting? Why are they trying to destroy Islam? Why? Do they control the mercy of Allah? Or are they in control or ownership of the universe? جُنْدٌ مَا هُنَالِكَ مَهْزُومٌ مُنَ الْأَحْزَامِ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned some of the nations before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to reconcile him, to assure him, to give him a strength. And تِلْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءُ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهَا إِلَيْكَ لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. Allah says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we reveal these stories to you to increase your steadfastness, to increase your resolve, to empower you, to keep your optimism up. So if these stories and these ayahs increase the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in iman, he doesn't need increase in iman. We need it most. We need it most. So when we read the stories, we also need to increase in our iman. We need to increase in our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to increase in our will to serve that deen. Allah mentioned قوم نوح. كذبت قوم لهم قوم نوح وعاد وفرعون ذي الأوتاد وثمود وقوم لوط وأصحاب الأيكة أولئك الأحزاب. So many nations before have been rejecting and belying and accusing the prophets, Allah destroyed them all. In kullun illa kathab al-rusul. All the prophets, they belied the prophet. فَحَقَّ عِقَابٍ. The punishment was due for them. It's not because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to punish people. No, people deserve it. وَمَا يَنْظُرُ هَؤُلَاء إِلَّا صِيحَةً وَاحِدًا مَا لَهَا مِنْ فَوَاقٍ. The kuffar of Arabia say something horrible. One time they said, as a dua, they said to Allah, رَبَّنَا إِنْ كَانَ هَذَا الْحَقُّ مِنْ عِنْدَكْ فَأَمْطِرْ عَلَيْنَا حَجَرًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. They said, oh Allah, if that is the truth that Muhammad is calling us for, make it rain stone on us. Bring the punishment. Not guide us. If this is the truth, destroy us. That's what they say. This is the amount of stubbornness and hatred to the deen of Islam at the beginning. In here they say, وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا عَجِّلْ لَنَا قِطَّنَا قَبْلَ يَوْمِ حَسَابٍ. Allah, send the punishment, ridiculing and just making, you know, just mocking the message and the messenger. Just punish us, just send us, show us where is the punishment. Allah tell the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and it's also for us, because the mockery is going on all the time now. Allah says, اصبر على ما يقولون. Patience. Have patience. The decision is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a timeline that nobody can change. Nobody can change. اصبر على ما يقولون واذكر عبدنا داود. Be patient and persevere and remember our servant Dawood. And then Allah mentioned Dawood. Why? Dawood come first? Because he was maybe one of the most righteous human beings. He's not just a prophet, not a scholar, not a judge, not only that, not a king, not only that. He used to fast on alternative days, day in and day out, fasting. And every single night he would pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet said, أحب الصيام إلى الله. Allah loves most the siyam of Dawood. أحب الصلاة إلى الله. Loves most the prayer of Dawood. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him miracles has not been given to any human being. The most beautiful voice when he recites the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah says, even the mountains will recite with him. The birds who are flying over him, they can't pass when they hear his voice praying. They will wait and repeat with him. So some people will say this was reflection or echoing of